So with that said, I'm going to hand it over to Colonel Alan West. He's got a long bio of just awesome heroic deeds. He's written a few books. We've got them in the back. Colonel Alan West.
Thank you so much, Ollie. He's a lot smarter than I. He was in the Air Force. I was in the Army. Yesterday was National Airborne Day. I don't know when there'll ever be a National Air Force Day. That's okay. Hey, look, I want to say thank you so very much for having me down here. And yes, it is a Saturday. And Raul, if this had been a college football Saturday, I don't know if I'd be here. But I want to introduce to everyone my my family, my wife, Dr. Angela Graham West, through the Brain Trust. Our oldest daughter, Aubrey West, who's a board-certified PA. And our youngest daughter is at flight attendant training in Phoenix, but she sends her
regards. Mike G, you wanted in the front. Michael G.
Michael G, you wanted in the front. Look, I think some of you all know that I announced Thursday night that I'll be running for the state chairmanship of the Republican Party here in Texas. Yeah! So, so let me explain why I'm here. Leadership, as I understood it in my 22 years in the United States Army, is all about bringing people together for the accomplishment of a common goal, a common objective, a unifying purpose. So my being here is not about endorsing Rahul. My being here is about going out and getting face to face with all the candidates that want to step up to serve us here in the great state of Texas. But more importantly, it's about being in front of each and every one of you to hear your concerns, to hear your thoughts, hear your insights and perspectives. Because what I want to do is make sure that this great state of Texas, this Lone Star State, it stays in the column of being a constitutional conservative state. So that those little kids that are sitting back there with their mommy and daddy, 50 years from now, they can still come here to Blanco Barbecue, and they can still be proud conservative, proud Republicans here in the great state of Texas, here in Bexar County, here in San Antonio. That's our purpose. That's our objective. That's why I am here today. Yeah. And if I keep coming down here, I'm going to have to buy some property. I was just here last week Friday. Let me tell you my story. You're looking at a guy who was born in 1961 in the inner city of Atlanta, Georgia, the old 4th Ward neighborhood. Some of you that may have been to Atlanta, Georgia, maybe some of you have been to Ebenezer Baptist Church, have been to see the final resting spot of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Guess what? That's the neighborhood that I grew up in. And right across the street was my elementary school, Our Lady of Lourdes Catholic School, from his final resting spot. And when I remember those seminal words of Dr. King, when he wanted to have a country where our children were judged by the content of their character, not by the color of their skin. This is why we have to reject this progressive socialism, because it has taken us back to evaluate and look at people based upon the color of their skin. The American dream is right here. A father that was born in 1920 in South Alabama, grew up in South Georgia, that served this country in World War II. A mother that was born in 1931 in South Georgia that did almost 25 years civilian service with the Marine Corps headquarters. And my dad at the age of 15 challenged me to be the first officer in our family because he was just a corporal. My older brother was a Lance Corporal in the United States Marines. That's what America's about. And when we think about the choice that we have, and I shared this last week, we can either go down the path of creating the next generation of victors, or we're going to create the next generation of victims. And Texas ain't about creating victims. But there is a voice that is coming to Texas that is repulsive, it is antithetical to everything that we believe in this great state. That rugged, indomitable, entrepreneurial individualism that defines what Texas is. And we have to have voices to stand up against that. In 1961, when I was born in Atlanta, Georgia, like I said, in a blacks-only hospital, Goose Falls, the two-parent household in the black community is between 75 and 77%. Mm. Today it's 24%. And you ask yourself, why? Well, there was a guy just from up the road here. They got a real nice presidential library for him up there, I think, in Austin, Texas. But when you look at the policies that Lyndon Baines Johnson created, they destroyed the black community. And now I got to share this with my Hispanic brothers and sisters. Because see, my parents were registered Democrats. John Lewis was my congressional representative. But my parents raised us conservative in nature. They believed in faith. They believed in the strength of family. They believed in a quality education. They believed in individual responsibility. They believed in the free market economic system. I always tell people, when I was growing up, my dad didn't give me an allowance. He gave me a lawnmower. And service to the country. I'm the third of four generations that have served this nation, all of us in combat. My nephew is currently serving up at Fort Sill, Oklahoma. He's already done 3 combat tours of duty as well. That is the cornerstone of who we are. And to my Hispanic brothers and sisters, if you're not careful, you're going to move from the column of being victors to the column of being victims. Because what the progressive socialist left needs are victims. They need people to be dependent upon them. They don't believe in independence, they believe in dependence. They don't believe in the individual, they believe in the collective. How can you have an economy that works for everybody when God gave us all our own individual gifts and talents? As a matter of fact, Thomas Jefferson wrote about the pursuit of happiness. Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, none of them. They cannot guarantee your happiness. But that is what they're trying to do. And it's so important that we talk to our young people. You know, my daughter here just signed a contract for her own first home up in Carrollton, Texas. Yeah, she's 26. But think about it. She's 26, and the man that commanded the Alamo for those 13 days, that wrote that incredible letter, he was 26 too. That's the type of millennials that we should have. Millennials that understand commitment to principles and values. Millennials that want to be a victor. As William Barry Travis said, victory or death. So it's time that we come together. When we talk about this immigration issue, let me tell you something. My wife's dad came to the United States of America from Jamaica. He was up in New York. And he ran into this guy that asked him if he wanted to get a nice haircut. Turned out to be a U.S. Army recruiter. Well, her dad served this country for 24 years. 2 tours of duty in Vietnam. He is now buried in Arlington National Cemetery. He was a legal immigrant. When Angela and I got married, she had a green card. And I told him, I can't be, mom and dad, they ain't gonna be happy with this now. I can't be marrying a foreigner, okay? But I will never forget the day that she was sworn in as a U.S. citizen in Kansas City, Missouri. That's what we want. When I hear people talk about free benefits going to people that are here illegally, when we have homeless and jobless veterans that have took an oath to support and defend this great nation, this constitution, this rule of law, and you have people that want to be president that don't want to abide by and stand up for our rule of law? No. And this right here in Texas is where we stop progressive socialism. Biggest export out of California. It's not wine, walnuts, or avocados. It's progressive socialism. It's overtaken Nevada, it's overtaken Arizona, it's overtaken Colorado, it's overtaken New Mexico, and now it's knocking on the doors. All you gotta do is drive down the I-35 corridor and see every major urban population center are controlled by whack job progressive socialists. The capital of the great state of Texas resembles more San Francisco than it does Texas.
That's right.
Houston, Harris County, El Paso, Corpus Christi. Even in the largest, reddest state, county, Tarrant, Senator Ted Cruz did not win that county. against Robert Francis O'Rourke. Do you want to be Hispanic dude? Okay? His nickname is Bob, okay? It's Bob. Don't say it, it's Bob. So they're here. Since I announced back on July the 3rd that we were going to explore the opportunity to be the next chairman here for the Republican Party, there have been countless amount of articles that have been written about flipping Texas.
Never.
Even one that was from The Economist said that you have to look at now Texifornia. The Democrats are now mocking us because of the four congressmen, one of which Congressman Hurd, that has decided to step down. They're calling it a Texodus. I don't like people mocking our state, our Republican Party, our constitutional conservative principles. You know, this is a fight. We're in an ideological battle, and you gotta fight. And if you're not willing to fight, then don't come out to events like this. But we need you to go out and find people that don't believe us, you do. Get three out of those five. We gotta have a ground game like no one has ever seen before. Because I don't think people wake up every day and they wanna be economically enslaved to government. But if that's the only message that they hear, Raul, they will fall for that. Why do I know? Because I've seen an entire community that used to be a proud community. Now look at Baltimore. Look at Dallas. Look at Houston and Harrisburg. Look at all of these major population centers and what has been happening to the black community. Austin.
Aaron Esther, what is
and it's
right
going to happen us? To the Hispanic community. And it's going to happen to the entire state. It's going to happen to the entire country. Let me close on this. Think about this incredible juxtaposition, the incredible irony of young people in Hong Kong taken to the streets to stand up against socialism and communism, marching with the United States flag, singing the national anthem in Hong Kong. And our young people here walked around in black, with black masks, talking about socialism. We got to teach our children well. I can stand here today, and our daughters are successful today, because Proverbs 22:6 says this: train up a child in the way that they should go, so that when they grow old, they shall not depart from it. That's how we're going to win. We take our message to our communities, we take our message to our children, we take our message to our grandchildren, and we talk to them about liberty and freedom. We tell the story of Texas and what it means for these great United States of America. There's only one flag in this country that can fly the same height as the American flag, and that's the flag of the place that we call home, the Lone Star State of Texas.